I'm Jess.
I'm Makayla.
I'm Anne.
And
we're decorating our gingerbread man that we made yesterday.
Everybody show your gingerbread.
Mine's broken because I tossed them on the ground, but there it is.
We are decorating. We have icing here, and then we have a bunch of sprinkles. So. Alright.
Oh, perfect.
Well, let's get just started.
Okay, I'm first going to fix his leg.
You just
know your
leg. So you tell yourself.
Oh, beautiful.
Oh,
yeah,
it's just
a little bit of
okay. You got some greens.
Oh yeah, the questions. We last minute asked for you guys to ask
sorry.
Us some questions. So
okay, so first question is, what are you most excited about for the upcoming new year?
Okay, so I'm gonna spread. Dear Daisy's album?
Yes. New yes. shows.
We are working on the album currently. How is that going?
Oh, fantastic.
It's really cool to see you guys, like how you guys work.
I was also gonna ask how our newcomers feel about joining in, like everything going good, like how's it?
How you feel?
How's your impressions and everything?
Yeah.
Good, honestly.
It's good to hear.
Like very good at planning. Yeah, but really together. It's like more together than I could ever be. Fucking in it.
So to be honest. At first, when I saw the messages from Robyn, I was like, is this a scam? I was like, I'm not sure about this, but I just say yes anyway. And when I actually met you guys there, I was like, okay, I love it.
Not a scam.
Yeah, I love it.
Not a scam.
Not a scam. Can I ask a question?
Yeah.
What brought everybody into performing?
I started out singing in church growing up, so yeah, and then I was in choir from 5th grade to my sophomore year.
Yeah. Okay, so, what got everybody else?
It's like this.
So I remember the very first time I sang on stage was for a talent show at my school. I was in 1st grade. And I literally stared at the spotlight the entire song. But I just really liked it, and I just kept singing after that.
Jess?
You know, I don't know.
Did you grow up a dance background?
Yeah, pretty much. It's like, I grew up singing, because like my mom put me in lessons.
Nice.
I started lessons when I was 5.
Wow.
And it was this dude that I don't remember his name, but I sang the Bare Necessities.
Aww.
At a recital, and I liked it, and then I got into middle school, and I did all years of middle school, but I did not like it very much.
As like choir?
Yes. Okay. And then I didn't do my 9th grade year of high school, so I was like, I'm not really in love with singing. So it was a very off year for me, you know? Mm-hmm. And then all of a sudden, that's kind of like the year that I kind of was like, I realized that I liked doing those things.
Yeah, you like felt the absence of
right.
That.
So I just decided that I wanted to get back into it. So I did the choir and everything. And then I have a friend I went to high school with. She mentioned ACM. And I was like, interesting. I had never performed on the stage until school.
Yeah, that's right. I remember.
The performance bands?
Mm-hmm.
Cute!
So I was just strictly a dancer, so I know how to like physically perform on stage, but never like be the actual spotlight of the stage, you know?
Yeah.
So it was very new to me at that point, and then I just fell in love with it.
And?
Well, always liked to sing and dance whenever I was a little. And when I still in like a middle school or high school, maybe kindergarten and everything, I've always like going to perform on my school stage.
Yeah.
And whenever I came to America, I have been looking for a group or like somewhere that doing something like this, because I have no idea like where I should go and where I should start.
Yeah.
So it's like, it's kind of boring to me, and I really want to like do that again. So I went to an audition, and somehow
I'm here. Connection. Yeah. I had done, my mom sang and she started taking voice lessons at a little community theater. She asked me to do a play there. I did that and then just kind of had fun. Did choir, did musical theater in college before I came to ACM. Best decision ever to switch.
It's Sky. Hi.
Cool. Hi,
who
Sky.
Are some...
Hi, Sky.
Who are some of your musical influences / inspirations?
Like as a group? Mm,
just in general.
In general, I guess.
Down the line.
I am obsessed with Will Smith, and I will never. This is like
Will Smith.
Will Smith.
Oh, I was like, wait, what?
Will Smith has shaped. I mean, Will Smith is responsible partially.
Yeah.
Will Smith, Chloe and Halle.
Mm. Oh. Yeah, they're awesome.
Like, more recently, like, now that I'm in, I don't know, like, this year, a lot of heart, because I've gotten into rock a lot more since going to ACM.
Yeah.
Rock kids.
I got into groups in the first place from seeing the Stunners. No one's heard of them? Mm-hmm. They, okay, so you know Tinashe and Hailey Kyoko?
Oh, yeah!
They were in a girl group.
What?
Wait, really?
Forever ago, they were in a girl group together.
Like pre-solo career, or
yes.
Like? Oh my god!
Yes.
Never.
And Hailey Kiyoko?
Uh-huh.
What?
Yeah.
Okay, called the Stunners.
Yeah.
Interesting.
I was obsessed with them, and then.
I love you too.
Yeah. I was obsessed with Girls' Generation. Yeah, I like groups a lot. I'm currently into Stray Kids and ATEEZ a lot.
Grew up with Queen and Nickelback.
Oh, I love Queen.
So instead of Christmas music, on Christmas, when we would decorate, we would play Nickelback and Queen.
Mm. Heck yeah. Awesome.
So it was very much like I grew up into that type of scene.
Yeah.
And my brother listened to that, and I listened to Flyleaf. Dude, I love Flyleaf. And then I kind of grew into like, I started loving...
Rolling away.
Whitney Houston.
Oh, heck yeah.
I kind of grew into Whitney Houston. And Whitney Houston is who got me, like I would listen to her so much and try to sing her songs when I, you know, mm-hmm. couldn't. And then it got me into like wanting to perform and be like as open and as like broad as her voice is, you know?
Powerhouse.
Yeah, and so if you can tell, I kind of have a very voice, so
yes.
I learned from her.
I love a lot of artists, honestly. I guess my top two would be, I love Michael Jackson. He's definitely one of my inspirations.
Nice.
I'm obsessed. And Harry Styles, have to be. His style for me, like, kind of different, so it's kind of cool to see.
Well, I listen to a lot of artists,
mm-hmm.
but for like K-pop, I like BTS and Blackpink and other groups, but that is my top two like groups that I'm supporting is actually following.
Yes.
But with like American artists, I like Cardi B.
Because
she's really funny and yeah. I know her song is sometimes we cannot listen to it like in public, but anyway, it's still
period.
Yeah. And Halsey, you guys know her, yeah.
Yes.
And let's see who else. Selena Gomez.
Love Selena Gomez.
Yeah.
That's my girl right there.
Yeah.
She's one of my crushes, I must admit.
So there is someone asked us that when you guys start producing music, are you all going to do an album, mini album, or a single?
I'm doing an album and a single.
Doing multiple singles.
Doing multiple singles.
And then an album.
And an album.
So it's like singles to keep everyone satisfied a little bit, and then
yeah.
Album,
oh.
Bring it all together.
Yes. Full album.
Yes.
And it's gonna be so good.
I'm excited.
I'm excited too. 100%.
Me too.
What's everybody's favorite track?
We haven't said the titles yet.
Okay, so we don't say the titles.
No. Oh. That's a secret.
Let's give a hint. So let's not say the actual title, but like something that has to do with it. That we understand that they won't.
Okay.
17-year-old rapping.
17-year-old?
You know this song when you were 17.
17-year-old rapping.
And it has rapping.
Yes.
We are delving into rapping in
this song. Yeah. It's a bop, honestly.
Very interesting to say the least.
My favorite is
Heck yeah. Dang. Yeah, that one's a really good one. But so is that one. They're all good.
I still gotta say the
rapping 17-year-old.
Yes, it's my absolute favorite.
That's
my
favorite.
That's the one that you like.
Yeah.
I love that.
Actually the first one that comes out as a single.
Yeah,
it's coming.
She's like, yes it is. Get excited, people.
But also I like another one. I also like another one.
Which one?
Hint.
Okay, I got it.
I was thinking give and take. I was like, wait.
Give and take?
That's old.
No, it's not. It's just.
Yes.
Yeah.
Gotcha.
I'm
gonna give a hint for my favorite one, but I've said it so many times.
Just whisper it in Robin's ear and she'll figure one out.
Okay.
I got it. Okay, so I guess the one from Bella. What's your favorite song to perform live? So I guess
we could say which one we've enjoyed performing live and which one you guys look forward to doing live.
Yeah, we could.
The one I enjoy doing live the most, I would say Run With It, but dancing while singing is not very pleasant.
People love it.
It's
people love
more
it.
Stressful though, but.
Yeah. Jess is not gonna agree with me, but only reason why I say Run With It is because that's the song that gets everyone so hyped.
True.
Everyone sings and dances to us with that one.
Well, okay, my choices change because of the na 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 part.
Yeah, everyone gets hyped for the na na na's.
I like Shameless.
Shameless?
Shameless.
Just because it's very, like, it's chill, but it's hard, you know?
Yeah.
Like, it goes hard, but it's chill.
Yeah.
I'm not a big... I like dancing, but dancing and singing, it requires so much more brain power than you think stressful. It does.
Yeah.
And it requires so much, like, practice, like, the amount of times that we rehearse, just trying to keep our stamina up.
Yeah.
Because... halfway through, we're dying, literally.
But you know, the crowd has fun in the end when we do it all. So.
And I do like to watch performances with dancing and singing the most.
Just the most
actually
entertaining.
Performing it is a little hard.
Yeah. Okay, what are you guys most excited to perform from our old album?
I need to look at the list of songs.
Could be from the new album too, I guess. Just do another hint.
For the old one, I actually like Change.
Yeah.
Yes. Change is a good one.
Yes. Yeah. I feel like
speaking
I'm
of,
familiar with Run With It and Change.
Yeah.
But Daylight, I like that.
Yeah.
I like that. I see the video. I see like the moves too. I'm like, that would be fun.
My only beef with that one is the fact that it's hard to sing.
It's so hard to sing live. Right? Yeah.
The melody's like,
it's a lot of movement very fast.
Yeah.
And the new one, I like.
Yeah.
Also the rapping.
That one's gonna be fun.
Oh, yeah.
That one's gonna be fun.
That'll
too.
Be fun.
Yeah.
Because it just kind of comes out of nowhere too, because the song's like chill and then all of a sudden.
Yeah.
On this next album, all of our songs are pretty much upbeat. Except for one.
Yeah. Maybe two, actually.
How many dancing? We have about four dances?
Yeah, four.
Yeah, we have four dances planned.
And they're gonna be fire.
From my friend Chasey, what's your favorite and least favorite part of it all? So anything having to do with the music and the group?
My favorite is Not this, because I'm eating them. It's a hard one. Because, I mean, all of it is pretty fun. I think putting the album together is probably what's the most fun. Seeing how it builds and learning the dances is a lot of fun, too.
Really?
I was gonna say the opposite.
Really?
I think the most fun part for me is learning the dance.
Yeah.
Like, doing the dance practice.
It's probably not fun for you, because you're the one that
has to figure it out. No, see, what I'm, like, my favorite part is, like, the songs finally being out and people finally getting
into them. That's true. That's true.
And everything being done. We already have choreography. Everything's out. I don't hate it, but it's just very, like, tedious. Just, like, doing the album, like getting it there to that point.
Yeah.
I'm just like, I just want it to be out already.
It gets stressful.
Yeah.
But yeah, once it's out, everyone's like, oh yeah, like getting into it. That's probably one of the
best parts. Especially after that first song comes out, you're like, okay, the next song, the next song,
right? My least favorite would probably be writing the songs because, like, every time we're done, we're drained.
Yeah.
We're so really tired. Like, all right, bye. I'm going.
I mean, with this new album, we have two more brains.
Yes. Yeah.
So it's been a lot easier. Actually, it's been a lot easier because Caprie's brain is like, it's the first thing to say. So
it was not as bad.
We got a lot of different ideas this time that, like, us three never really thought of.
Yeah.
They, like, came in and they were like, this, that, the other. And we're like, whoa. Yeah.
We ran out of space on the memory card, so that's why the video looks different now.
And so, Anna, what is your favorite part right
now?
That's
how they did it.
Okay. You're, like, holding his looker, but I'm just like.
The part that I like is, like, going to perform on a stage. Yes. I love that.
Yeah.
What's your least favorite right now? There's none? Great.
Yeah, for now.
For now. We'll ask again when the album's over. We'll ask again. Okay, what's the next part of that question?
What TV shows did we grow up watching?
Oh.
Interesting.
Random.
Okay, grow up, select an age. Because, like,
I've watched so many.
Most influential show of childhood.
I liked Zoe 101.
I was more of a Disney girl, so, like, Where's the Wesley Place? And, like, Zack and Cody and stuff like that. Hannah Montana, yeah.
Absolutely.
I liked Lost.
Lost is a good show.
As a child?
Like, yeah. I didn't watch that until, like, maybe, like, late middle school or early high school, but.
I was the youngest in a family of adults, so.
Gotcha.
Same. Yeah. Literally same.
Not an influential show, but just one that was, like, I've watched way too much. My Strange Addiction.
Oh my gosh, yes.
Especially, like, the YouTube clips, though. Like, the YouTube rundowns of what was happening.
I remember every episode. I can't even lie. Because it was so weird.
There was a lot.
Oh
my god. But I really like Avatar: The Last Airbender. That was a good
show. Oh yeah,
I like Avatar. I watch Avatar now.
Yeah, yeah. Like, you, and every time you watch it, it's just like you learn. Yeah. You just relate in a different way. It's a really sweet show.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if Barbies count.
Barbie, oh my god,
I had Barbies as a kid.
Oh my god, girl,
with Barbies and Tom and Jerry.
I love Tom and Jerry.
Yes.
I just watched that literally the other day.
Why?
Yeah. I don't know. I just felt like watching Tom and Jerry.
Yeah, it's on Hulu. I watched The Wiggles.
Oh, I love The Wiggles.
My two favorites were The Wiggles, Blue's Clues.
Oh, love Blue's Clues.
And there's another one. It's I forget what it's called every time, but it's whenever they go through a different door and they end up somewhere else.
Dragon Tales?
Okay, first of all,
Dragon Tales. Not the Dark
Yardigans. Fire.
Yeah.
We have to get
the no cable. We have to get the PBS.
Oh my god.
But it's a show where, like, they have, like, little puppet things. There's these guys, like, two of them, I think.
Upside down show?
Yes! Yes!
That was a good show.
I love The Backyardigans.
Backyardigans, amazing.
Who's your favorite? I like Pablo.
I only know Uniqua. Yeah, we're like the D name, the yellow guy, Donovan.
There is no Donovan. The only yellow one was the hippo, and that was Tasha.
Oh,
Oh, okay. I miss Austin.
There was Austin.
Austin's a kangaroo.
Yeah. Talk about Austin and Allie, man.
Austin and Allie was good. That's when we were older, though.
If we go like non-cable, we got Arthur, Curious George.
Curious George. I hated Curious George.
Oh my gosh. What?
He made me so mad.
Oh my gosh. Like, she's a whole like, this is too much chaos.
I'm a monkey.
He's like, there's no order. There's no order.
You drove me insane. I hated it.
Do you want to show our art?
Let's show our gingerbread piece.
Our ginger people.
Okay, introduce yourselves.
Okay, so first up, me! This is mine. What he has a broken name? Leg. His name is Bert.
Wow.
This is my little guy. Their name is... Twin. Their name is Twin.
Twin.
This is mine. She's a girl. Because she had to dress and yeah.
Yes.
She have a huge lip though. I actually yeah. Her name.
She's got the fillers.
A.
A.
Just A.
A. It's period. Very Pretty Little Liars.
Heck yeah, A.
Mine.
This is Robyn. Is,
I call it Alien in a Speedo.
Sorry.
Heck yeah.
That's it.
Last mine. Mine is.
I love that name.
Yeah, that's the name. It looks like it's gonna stare into your soul when you sleep. So it's fine. So yay!
Great.
I guess
it's up the vote. I don't know. It's gonna be two of them then. But
yeah. So there was episode 2. Thanks. Someone say something.
Thanks for joining us in Daisy Days.
Yes, we have had fun so far.
There will be more.
A lot of fun.
We'll see you next episode.
Bye.
Bye.